Man, I love college.
Do I really have to graduate, or can I just stay here for the rest of my life?
Keno Radio. Keno Radio. Keno Radio.
We got beer and a tub and some good-looking girls dressed to the nines, looking for a good time. Jacked up trucks. In thick white rocks stuck in the mud grip, and a big old bouncer at the door, but don't show him your ID.
What's going on, gang? How you doing? It's your boy Kicks here, and it's just me right now. It's just me for now, but don't get worried. This isn't going to be a super long episode. You're not going to listen to me banter for an hour about nonsense. This episode actually has some structure. This episode actually has some meaning behind it. This episode is the official preview, let you know what's going on with the Keno Radio Podcast Across America tour. I just felt like as you saw today, the reason you're listening to this is because we got the link set up, we got the donation center set up, we have officially launched the Keno Radio Podcast Across America tour. It's officially happening. I told the parents, long awaited. I told Papa Wake, not a whole big reaction out of him, kind of expected. Didn't really know, but I wanted his approval. The big thing with him is I was going to do it anyways. I was going to go on this tour anyways regardless, but it's kind of like a bride and groom getting married. You're going to do it anyway if the love is there, but you would like to have the father of the bride's permission so it will go smoothly. I think that is a spot-on analysis. Way to go, Kyle. I got the approval from my mom, my dad, and I told the employers, so they know I'm done. I'm done where I'm working right now, or at least a little vacation. I don't think it warranted vacation, but I'm taking a vacation anyways to make this happen. So this episode's just kind of a little breakdown of what's going on, what the next 4 weeks up until the road trip are going to entail, what the 4, 5, 6, 7, maybe 52 weeks of the road trip are going to entail as well. So I'm just going to kind of dive into it. First things first, if you have heard of this from someone else and you're not a Keno Radio guy, you heard it because hopefully someone shared this or you heard about it on a news station or you heard about it somewhere. I am Kyle Wakefield. I am the host of Keno Radio, the creator of Keno Radio. I go by Kicks, Captain Fun, whatever you want to call me. You're going to hear a bunch of those names along the way. And my plan is to go around the country and the money that I raise is going to donate to the National MS Society. We have a little donation set up there. So the big idea behind this, the Keno Radio Podcast Across America tour, there's a couple stages to it. I'm going to break down of how I came up with this idea. But the big one that I want to hone in on, emphasize on, is the fight against MS aspect of it. So the big idea is every dollar donated, I'm going to drive that many miles around the country. So that's kind of where the tie-in between the money is. A lot of people do the races, a lot of people do the walks, they do this, they do that, they do bike stuff. I was like, you know what, I don't know a ton of people that do road trips for this. I'm not a runner. If you know me at all, I'm not a runner. I'm not a biker. I'm hardly an athlete. But I love road trips. I love myself a road trip. I love that aspect of it. So I was like, this is going to be cool. So just a little background on me. If you don't know me, 23 years old, graduated from University of Massachusetts Amherst in May of 2016. My life's pretty much been on hold until this. I came up with this idea. So here we go. I came up with this idea back in June 2016. I was like, you know what? I've always wanted to do a road trip. I've always been a huge road trip guy. Always super into it. Love anytime I go on vacation. I grew up on road trips. We used to road trip down to Hilton Head Island, South Carolina, every single April vacation when I was growing up. So I was built on road trips growing up. Spring break last 2 years, people are flying down. I'm like, nope, I'm hitting the road. So I love living the car. I've always wanted to take a cross-country road trip. So that's always been in my brain. And then I figured, you know what? I'm graduating. I don't really have a job. I should do this at some point. I didn't have any money after college. So I was like, oh, I can't do it right away. Like I probably should have done, so I could have got my life together. So I was like, all right, I'm going to try to do it in the fall. And then I was like, oh, let's incorporate Keno Radio to this. Like, let's make this the Keno Radio Podcast Across America tour. Because, obviously, I like doing this stuff. I want to make Keno Radio a thing. I would like to make this a legitimate thing, a legitimate job for me. I like to go around. I like to meet people. I like to talk to people. So I was like, you know what? Doing a podcast across America tour, that could ruffle some feathers. That could get me some new viewers, kind of a promotional tour type of thing like that. So for a while, that was the idea. I was like, I'm just going to do this road trip. I'm going to do a podcast across America tour. I'm going to try to get Keno Radio's name out there. So for like pretty much the summer, that's where my head was at. And I was planning on doing the fall. I want to do it in September, kind of college football would be cool, something like that. Didn't have enough money. Just didn't have a car. Didn't have enough money. So it wasn't working. So I pushed it back to April. I could have probably done it. I had the money. I haven't pretty much saved anything since like November. But I wanted good weather. So I could have probably done it if December was June. It could have happened. If the seasons were flip-flopped, if we lived in Australia, it would have been done sooner. I would have already been done by now, hopefully famous, and Keno Radio is to the moon, but we had the winter time, so I pushed it off to April. I figured we're going to go south first, we're going to hit the warm weather, and then by the time we come back up north, it's going to be nice weather, it's going to be springtime, it's going to be awesome. So then like August-ish rolls around, this could be a little off, I don't really remember, but I think August rolls around, and it just like, I woke up, I was like, let's do the, for every dollar we donate, we drive that many miles. Like my mom, so the big thing, my tie-in with MS, is my mom, Jude's, has MS. She's had it for the last 14 years, as well as her sister had it. Her sister sadly passed away a couple years back, I think 2008. And she had MS as well. She died due to complications due to MS. And now my mom has it and has had it. And she's been a warrior. She's been just tough as nails, grinding it out, smile on her face every single day. I can't say enough about it. But it sucks. It's straight up is, in my eyes, is the worst disease out there because there's no cure at all. It's slow. It's, you see the non-progress, digress, is that the word? The non-progress over the years, it's very in your face. You can absolutely live with it. I mean, she's still working every day. She's, like I said, a warrior. And it affects a lot of people. And I just, my big thing is I also don't think it gets the light that it should. And I'm not taking away from any other disease. I mean, every disease deserves the light of day. They all suck. They're all the worst. But this one just hits so close to me personally. I was like, you know what? Let's try to do something about this. Let's try to raise some money and hopefully try to raise awareness as to what MS is, because it affects so many people. And because, like I said, it's so personally close to me that I wanted to do something about it. So that's why I brought in the MS aspect of, hey, let's not really focus on trying to get famous. That, if that happens, that happens. If Keno Radio blows up because of this, I will be ecstatic. I'm not going to sit here and lie to you and say I wouldn't be ecstatic. I would be the greatest thing in the world because this is what I love to do. This is what I want to do. This is what I see myself doing. And I've always wanted to do the road trip. But I figured, you know what? That's more of a destiny thing. That's not me. I can't really control that. That is kind of a bigger picture thing. I'm going to leave that up to the big man. If it's meant to be, it's meant to be. What I can control is these donations and raising awareness and talking to people and meeting different people and seeing their stories and seeing other people living with MS and seeing how they react to it and how their family members react to it and everything like that. I can actually change, hopefully, at least someone's day. I'm not going to say their life. I'm not going to sit here and be... say I can save someone's life. I can hopefully bring a smile to someone's face and talk to them about it and say, hey, you're not alone. You have MS. There's plenty of people out there, and that's why I want to raise money. So that's why I kind of spin zone this thing to tie it into the MS aspect to hopefully raise a ton of money. That's my goal. I want to raise a ton of money because I'm going to drive around the country regardless. No matter if we raise $100, I'm not going to drive to Amherst and back. I'm driving around the country regardless. But I think it'd be so much cooler. And it would just look awesome. It would feel awesome if I raised it. If it became a challenge, if we raised $10,000 and I had to drive 10,000 miles, we raised $20,000 to something crazy like that, where it's like, hey, I want to stay on the road as long as possible. I want to be on the road for 50,000 miles. I don't know if the Buick 05 Buick LeSabre is gonna want that, but I do. So my big thing is I want to get the word out there. I want to raise awareness and I want to raise so much money to donate to the National MS Society. And what you can do, I'm going to plug this at the end too, so don't feel like you're going to miss it now. Where's my mouse cursor? The link to donate, it's all going to be on our Facebook page. It's all going to be on our Twitter, our Instagram, our normal website, all those, Twitter, Instagram, both at Keno Radio, facebook.com/Keno Radio. And the website is www.kinoradio.wixsite.com/let's have some fun. Everything's going to be all up there. But if you want to go directly to the page, it's HTTP. I don't know if you still need that these days. /main.nationalmssociety.org/go-to/KenoRadio. KenoRadio. So that's the direct fundraising page. If you want to pause the podcast and go donate, that would be fantastic. So that's the big MS aspect of it. That's what I really am excited for. I really want to raise a ton of money for that. And go from there. So, but on the flip-flop side, the thing that I kind of want to tie in with the Keno Radio, which I think would be cool, is you're not just raising money and then that's it. You know? You're not just raising money and then someone's going to go do something with it. You're going to see, you can follow my adventure the whole time. Because, like I said, there is the MS factor, but there's also the Keno Radio Podcast Across America tour factor. So you can follow along on Snapchat, at Keno Radio, same thing, as well as, like I said, on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all that stuff. I'm going to be updating every single day. I'm going to be doing podcasts, bare minimum once a week, probably a couple of weeks because I'm going to be bored. So the whole time, I'm going to be going around, and I'm going to be creating content, and I'm going to be creating feedback and access to see what I'm doing and hopefully see these stories of all these people. I'm going to highlight not only MS people either. I want to highlight everything. I want to meet celebrities. I want to get cool content like we've been doing, or not like we've been doing, but to get Keno Radio kind of more legit is have big names come on and kind of give cool interviews, because you want to see. And like I said, it's not gonna be a sad sap tour. It's not gonna be all sympathy and everything like that. That's not how we roll. I know that's not how Jude lives her life, so that's not how we're gonna do this tour. She's not looking for sympathy every day. That's not what we're gonna be doing. We're going to be out. We're going to be creating laughter. We're going to be making memories. We're going to be making smiles on people's faces. This is Spread the Love Tour just as much as it is Raise Awareness Tour. We want to unify. When I was talking to my dad about it, he said, take this situation you have and take advantage of it. You have this opportunity where you're going to ride around the country. You're going to meet a ton of new people. You don't really have a schedule. You don't really have all these. You don't have any commitments. Take this opportunity and better yourself, and better the world. Unify people. As everyone knows right now, this country is so ridiculously divided. And again, I'm not naive enough where I'm going to go out here and say I'm saving the world, or I'm making a difference, or anything like that. But just one person at a time, if you can make one, I'm going to try to make one person a day laugh, or smile, or meet one new person a day, and get their phone number, and hey, maybe stay in touch with them for the road trip, or longer than that. And that's where the other aspect, the spread the love and the hashtag smile with a stranger, that's going to be one of the campaigns. Every single day, I'm going to put up at least 1 gram on the @KenoRadio Instagram. And it's just going to be a totally random person and just a nice smile with them. Give them a little hug, take a picture, maybe give them a compliment, and that's it. Just easy, simple as that with the hashtag smile with a stranger. And hopefully it'll make their day. Go up to them, hey, man, I really like your shoes. Those things are killer. Like, I wish I had cool shoes like that. Mine are $14 from Walmart, and they're all dirty and beat up. Your shoes are really nice. Can I grab a picture? Go on with your day, man. Handshake, high five, dap them up, whatever, something like that. Just do something. Reach out to someone just quick, right on the street. Quick, something like that. Quick, hey. Make them happy. That's the big thing on this whole thing. The whole Keno Radio thing, too, is we just want to bring joy and bring fun. I mean, the slogans, let's have some fun. My whole thing, make America fun again. We get caught up in this 9-to-5, and it's so easy for me to say that. I mean, I know. I have such a fake life. I totally agree with that. I'm the only person in this who has this stupid mindset where I graduate and I feel like I can do this. Instead of going out and getting a normal job like a normal human being, I put my life on hold, and I'm going on this ridiculous road trip at 23 when I have thousands of dollars in student debt and I should be getting after it. But hey, I'm a big believer in the fact that you only get one shot at this crazy thing you call life. You only get one shot at it. And this is something I've always wanted to do. And I think a lot of people forget that. And again, I know I'm young. I haven't lived any years compared to a lot of people. I don't understand what it's like to struggle. I don't understand a lot of these things in life. But I know the one thing that I think a lot of people forget about, and that we're here for fun. We're here for enjoyment. There's a lot of things. There's a lot of real stuff going on. There's a lot of things you got to be worried about. There's a lot of, you got all this stuff you got to pay for and everything like that. But at the end of the day, you do only get one shot at it, you know? And like George Strait said, you're not here for a long time. You're here for a good time. So you might as well take advantage of it when you can. And that's kind of one of the messages that I want to go out there and spread the joy with is, hey, take a load off, man. Like, you don't have to always stick to the script. You can get a little crazy. You can do something different. Whether it's just a little bit of 5 minutes a day, enjoy yourself. Just something like that. So kind of want to just raise awareness to the fact that, hey, life's pretty cool, man. Like, you have the ability to do whatever you want in this life. And I know that's so cliche, but, and this is such a small little thing for it. It's just a small little blip on my life map. But I said, hey, I want to do a road trip. I want to raise some money. I want to try to make it with Keno Radio. So I'm going to go out there and do it. And that is kind of the mindset that I want to bring along with me for this whole trip. So that's the background information about the Keno Radio Podcast Across America Tour. Now, this is kind of just, I have a list of celebrities I want to meet. Like I said, I want to get cool people. I don't just want to do this for me. I want to do it to make Keno Radio a cool thing. And people turn to that and be like, oh, that's a cool podcast. They had so-and-so on. So a list of celebrities is kind of all over the place. It's kind of long, but I'm just going to pepper through it so you can see, hold me up to my expectations, see what I want. So first guy, first and foremost, the guy, Jimmy Buffett. Jimmy Buffett is, he's the ultimate Margaritaville, the ultimate 5 o'clock. Like, Jimmy Buffett is who I inspire to be. He literally, like, Keno Radio is kind of built off of Jimmy Buffett's persona. The whole island time, the whole have a good time, the whole beach aspect of it. Jimmy Buffett's the man. So he's up there. And one of the other things I want to tie into, one of the goals, a little bucket list goal. See, and another thing of this is there's a lot of bucket lists that I want to check off of. One of which being hit all the Margaritavilles around the country. I think there's 12 scattered around the country. So I want to do that. I want to go to all the Margaritavilles, do some food reviews, everything like that, meet some people. But that's one little thing that I want to do. So go to all the Margaritavilles and hopefully meet Jimmy Buffett. Maybe if he hears that, I'm giving him all that business, he'll come on for a podcast. Guy Fieri, huge. If you remember Gary Filet, he was the inspiration behind Gary Filet. Guy Fieri, just absolutely all American. Love Guy Fieri. Has the best job, literally my exact job I want to do. Drive around the country and eat food on TV. Just perfect. Jake Owen just seems like a really cool guy. He actually, his music video for American Country Love Song, which I've been on record on Keno Radio saying is the best song of all time. His music video was, not gonna lie, a little bit of an inspiration for this. He drove from Nashville to Key West, Florida, and kind of just recorded it. And I was like, hey, that's kind of a cool idea. You know, it's like a little documentary style. So Jake Owen, I would love to see you. Hopefully, I'm going to tweet out and maybe get the love bus for the road trip so I don't take the Buick. Luke Bryan, easy, my boy, just the best. Steve Spurrier, hilarious, would love to see him. Van Wilder, I know that's technically Ryan Reynolds, but Van Wilder is my favorite movie character of all time, has some great life lessons, the best movie of all time. Jeff Sorum. Probably a lot of you don't know who Jeff Sorum is. Jeff Sorum is highly regarded as the greatest pond hockey player of all time, besides me, because I think I am. In the pond hockey documentary called Pond Hockey, he's the main feature of it. So I'd love to get him on, see kind of what his lifestyle is like, because he's awesome. Reba, just a huge Reba fan. Randy Moss, I want to go to the Randy Moss Football Academy in West Virginia, and hopefully talk to him, see what's up, play with him, everything like that. Randy Moss, my favorite football player of all time. Absolutely love him. He's even better as an analyst. Probably not because he's the best football player ever, so he's great, just as good as an analyst. Randy Moss, huge. Jennifer Aniston, all-time number one. I don't know if this one will happen. She's a little A-list for me, but I would love to because Aniston's number one for me. T-Swift, another. Just love T-Swift. She might be a little out of my league too, but we're going to try to get her. Dan Gilbert, famous tennis coach. Read the biography Open about Andre Agassi, and you'll understand why I want to meet Dan Gilbert. Dude is a legend. Larry David, probably the smallest chance to get, but the absolute king of comedy. So Larry David's on there. Asher Roth. I feel like I could actually get Asher Roth because he's kind of been out of the limelight for a while, but I love college. I mean, it's the intro song. It's the song. It was a song, one of my favorite songs of college. I mean, he's an ultimate college guy, and we can't forget that Keno Radio started as Everything College. So we got to get Ash Roth on. I would love that, and I think I have a shot at that. Marty Smith, best ESPN guy out there, just absolutely electric. Loves the South. I love the South. Marty Smith would be great. Bobby Bones, just the biggest country radio host out there. Rob Dyrdek was one of the first guys where I was like, okay, you can have fun in life. I know he has gajillions of dollars, so it's easier for him, but he kind of made it known, like, let's have fun with life, let's enjoy it. And he always just kind of spread positivity around. So I would like to talk to him about that. He's a dad now. People forget that, so we'll see. Chase Rice, awesome. Just, I've said I would love to trade lives with him. He'd be so cool. Jesse Palmer, in case you live under a rock, I've been saying for a long time now, Jesse Palmer is the all-time leader in kill count for females. Not like murder, but like I think he has slept with the most women of anyone in the history of the world. So I need him on so I can get a confirmation about that. While we were in Gainesville, I kind of had a confirmation. I asked some guy if it was true who worked for the SEC network, and he just kind of smiled and laughed and gave me like a, yeah, it is true. So I got to confirm that. Charlie Moore, the Mad Fisherman, has one of the best jobs ever. So I kind of got to figure out how I could do that. Just be a person on TV going fishing in New Hampshire. Tim Tebow, my all-time favorite athlete. That's all you got to know. Mikey Waltrip. If you don't watch NASCAR, he's the definition of electricity. He finished in eighth yesterday at the Daytona 500. Good for him. It was his last race ever. So he had a pretty good finish. Mikey Waltrip would be great. Ace Hood and Young Jeezy, just kind of great rappers that I kind of love back in the day, who I feel like you haven't heard from in a while, so they might be open for me to meet them and get on a podcast with them. Bob Sovin, professional wakeboarder, love the show Wake Brothers, seemed like an awesome guy. Todd Chrisley, one of my favorite shows out there, Chrisley knows best, he's too funny. Kevin Sumlin, big just football guy, seems awesome. Rachel Platten, love her, love Fight Song, love Stand By You. She's from Newton, maybe that's a connection. Kip Moore went 0 to 60 so fast for me. I just wasn't really that big into Kip Moore. He's awesome. His music is awesome. He seems like such a good guy. I would love to just chat with Kip Moore on or off the record. PK Subban, I mean, come on, the definition of electricity. Matt Stafford, the ultimate college bro playing in the NFL. And then Johnny Mack, John McEnroe. That would make my dad so jealous because that's his favorite athlete of all time. So that's for you. That's for you, Papa Wake. So that's the list of celebrities right there. It's a little ambitious. I know. Hopefully we'll get some people. We might get zero. We might get zero of them. We might get a bunch of them. We might get a bunch of cool other ones that I didn't even think of. So that's the list right there. That's what I'm going with. And then I just have a couple of bucket list things that I also want to try to knock off too. Because that's, like I said, that's the other aspect of it. I'm doing this. This is a once-in-a-lifetime thing for me. So I'm going to try to knock off as many cool things that I could do while I'm out there on top of all this. So one of the big ones I want to do, which I think would just be cool, I want to play Can Jam in every state. Shout out to Can Jam. It's quick to set up. It's easy to learn. The original Can Jam. It's anyone's game. It's America's number one party sport. You can play it at the beach. You can play it at the park. You can play it at the yard. You can play it at barbecues. Anything like that. Shout out Can Jam. Still don't know if they are our official, unofficial, some sort of sponsor, but I'm giving them a free shout out, free plug, anything like that. And I'm going to be playing it all around the country. So look for me. If you want to play in a game of Can Jam versus me, I'm going to play in all 50 states. I'm going to go 50-0, just a shout-out. Like, they're probably 48-0. I don't know if we're going to make it to Alaska and Hawaii. 48-0. I'm going to be looking for a teammate slash opponents the whole trip. So if you love Can Jam and you're listening to this, hit us up. Hit me up on Twitter. Hit me up on Instagram. Send out a challenge. Give me the time, place, state. I will be there, and I will win. Can Jam in every state. Going to be awesome. Then the Highway Happy Hour. The Highway Happy Hour is the big, if you don't know what it is, it's on the Highway, Channel 59, I think it still is, on XM Sirius Radio, hosted by Stormy Warren. And they kind of, Fridays at 5 to 8-ish, I believe, they kind of let people, outsiders, come on and just kind of share their story, what they're doing there, what their plans are for the weekend in Nashville and everything like that. So I want to get on that the first Friday I'm there, April 1st, I believe, and tell the story and really get the word out and use that as a platform to let everyone know what I'm doing. Hopefully get a lot of people to start following the trip. Hopefully get a lot of people to donate some money. So that's the real order business. The first leg is Boston and Nashville, and hopefully get the word out through Stormy Warren. And maybe get on Bobby Bones show, something like that, something cool like that. They love Tell Me Something Good. They love everything like that. So Nashville is a big spot. I'm a big country guy, as you guys all know. Nashville is a big starting location for me, and I hope something big comes out of Nashville. Because I think something might. It might not. But I think Nashville will be a good starting spot to really kick the tour off. So Boston, Nashville, look for us there that first weekend. Then like I was talking about Randy Moss, his football boot camp, I want to get in there. I want to get my butt kicked by Randy Moss. I want to throw some passes to him, catch some passes, everything like that. The Randy Moss boot camp in West Virginia, like I was saying, that's on the bucket list. Drive over the 32 bridge, Luke Bryan's 32 bridge. Luke Bryan, my boy. I want to do a podcast with Luke on the 32 bridge. I'm going to be on lookout for the most American town in the country. If you think your town's the most American, again, hit me up. I want to see what it's like. I want to get a big old slice of America. I've been in Boston my whole life. I don't really know the Midwest. I don't really know the South. I don't know the mountainous aspects or the left coast. I want to know what the most American town in the country is. And then a big one. I want to go to probably not all. I don't know if I'll make it, but Lake Margaritaville's. I want to visit a lot of the MS headquarters. I know we have one, the New England chapters in Waltham. So I'll probably swing by there. I want to do a podcast with someone there, kind of see what the MS Society is all about. But I would like to swing by those randomly and kind of volunteer, help out, maybe embark in one of the 5Ks they're doing, or go just talk to some patients, things like that. So I'm going to visit as many of those as I can, kind of keep them. I don't want them to just be the donation center and the figure. I want them to be hands-on with me, and I want to make this thing cool. I want to use them to propel me as well, to get the awareness up, to get all the orange going. Orange is the official color of MS. To get everyone wearing orange and anything like that. So I want to reach out and use them to really make this thing to the top. I already said all the Margaritavilles. That's a big one. Another real personal one for me. Play catch with Brett Favre. I think that would be in some Wrangler jeans. That would just be the coolest thing in the world to me. Brett Favre, my favorite quarterback of all time. Just the absolute gunslinger, absolute hick from Mississippi. If I could play catch with Brett Favre in Wrangler jeans in Mississippi, my life would be complete. We're going to give every state a rating, so look out for that. And we're not doing 10 out of 10s for every state. That's for darn sure. We're actually going to do real ratings for every state. I don't care if I'm in there for 15 minutes driving through Delaware, you're getting a rating. And then the only really big plan I have is the Tortuga Music Festival in Fort Lauderdale, April 7th to 9th. That's the only date that I want to be there. Luke's headlining, Kenny's headlining. I don't have tickets. I don't have any plans or anything like that. I'm going to go in. I'm going to try to get media passes. We'll see if we can. I'm actually going to do this after I record the podcast, try to get some media passes. But I want to go there. It's just any music festival will be good content, interview some people, hopefully catch Luke, Kenny, bunch of country people in there, hopefully get a media pass and really produce some content. That'd be awesome. And then the smile with a stranger, that's the other aspect of it. Hashtag smile with a stranger, that's gonna be a big hashtag. I want that to get trending. I want that to become a thing. Smile with a stranger, just bring light to everyone's day, make people smile, make people laugh, make people love each other again. Because at the end of the day, if you're not being happy, you're not being loving, you're not being kind to people, what's the point of even being here? You know, it's just so much better to be happy than to not be happy. That is what I've learned in my 23 years. It's probably the biggest thing I can take away, is life is easier, life is more satisfying, life is more fun when you're smiling than when you're frowning. So those are my big plans for it. And the last, kind of the last aspect, I just kind of yelled into the mic right there. The last aspect is just the trek, the journey, the plan, the map. We're going, so like I said, we're going Boston and Nashville. Then we're kind of going to swing back through the SEC and get to the coast, the Carolinas, Charleston, Savannah. Love those cities. Then we're going to swing down that first week. Like I said, we're going to go down to Fort Lauderdale, hit Tortuga, go all the way down. I want to go to the most southern part. I want to go to the Keys, real Margaritaville, hit the most southern part of the U.S., come back up Florida, across the Panhandle, swing through Alabama, swing by the Floribama, the famous bar. Maybe see Kenny Chesney there. Go across Alabama, across Mississippi into Louisiana, swing by New Orleans. I haven't been in a couple of years. We want to swing back to New Orleans. Make our way into Texas, Houston, Dallas, Fort Worth, that kind of area. Then we start to go up. This is where it gets a little wild. Instead of going straight across San Diego, we're going up. We're going to hit up. We're going to go through Texas into Oklahoma, or Oklahoma, New Mexico. So it's going to be a long trip in Texas. It's going to be a lot of miles in Texas, naturally, biggest state. Go through New Mexico, up into Colorado, Denver. Very curious about Denver. Hopefully meet Stevie B out there. That's the city he wants to go to. Denver, hook into Wyoming, and then into Utah, Salt Lake City, and come down through Utah all the way into Arizona, Grand Canyon region, Grand Canyon into Las Vegas, then go from Las Vegas to San Diego, hit San Diego all the way up the left coast, LA, San Francisco, San Jose, all the way up through California, into Oregon, Portland, into Seattle. Seattle is when we start going back right. Going to come across Washington to Montana, through Wyoming again, North Dakota, see Mount Rushmore. Very curious to see that, up into the Badlands of North Dakota. Diagonal through Minnesota, through St. Paul, through Wisconsin, and make our way to Chicago. Love Chicago. Would love to see that. Hopefully it's a nice day there in the Windy City. That's going to be later on in April. That's kind of why I coordinated this, because it's going to be going to want to get some time to warm up in those northern cities. And then Chicago, cross Michigan, swing through Detroit, see what the hype's all about. Go down to Ohio, through Pennsylvania. End of the trip, we're going to hit New York. The end, the Big Apple, I was going to do that. Was going to be one of the first stops and kind of kick it off, but I figured let's get the weather better, everything like that. NYC, the Big Apple, is going to be one of the last stops. And then either head home. This is probably going to be the end of April, beginning of May. We have Talladega in Alabama, May 7th, which we're planning on going to, just me and my buddies. So it's either head home and then go to Talladega, or depending on the date, where I am, head to Dega, back up, and then end it in New England again, in Boston. I don't really know, personally. I don't know how this long. In my brain, I'm going March 29th to May 10th, 11th, 12th, 15th, kind of like a five-weeker. I don't know how long it's going to last. I don't know. Maybe I'll get sick of it. At the end of the day, here's the thing. I'm going for it. I might hate it. I'm currently going alone right now. I have a couple buddies who say they're going to meet me out or go for a couple days. I don't have a co-host. I don't have a cameraman. I don't have a video guy. I don't have any of that stuff. I'm going solo, Jimmy. If you're listening and have any interest and can take a month off from work, can take a month off from the real world, let me know. I want a right-hand man there. I'm, like I said, I'm going alone as it is. I don't want to go alone. I want to make that very clear. I get lonely. I'm going to go crazy probably. That's the other thing. If I'm sitting in a car for 6 weeks by yourself, I might come out and be completely crazy. I might be completely tapped when I come out and might need to go in an asylum. I hope not. I hope I'm sane enough to not do that, but you never know. Hopefully I meet enough good people along the way, but my plan right now is to have my friends along, but hopefully use my communication skills I learned in college and my social skills and meet new people, maybe meet a co-host and a camera guy down somewhere and pick them up for the road trip. But if you're listening right now and you, or you know someone, or you know someone who knows someone, or you know someone who knows someone who knows someone who wants to join, who wants to be a part of the most epic road trip of all time, the greatest story you'll ever tell, hit me up. Hit me up. Send me an email. KenoRadio@gmail.com. Send me a tweet, DM, slide right in those DMs, Twitter, Instagram, anything like that. Just let me know. Or if you personally know me, shoot me a text. Shoot me a text. Let me know if you want to join, because like I said, I would love a partner in crime for this whole thing. And it's going to be the best 6 weeks of your entire life. So if you're out there, let me know. Shoot me a text. But I think that's it. I don't think there's any much more I got to say about this whole thing. I mean, the Keno Radio Podcast Across America to Fight MS Tour, it's happening. It is kind of scary because it's been in my brain for a long time now. And I held off my life for a while for it. I put my life on pause. Not that I had big old plans that were going to happen. I had nothing on the radar. But I have been treading water in life and not getting a real job because of this. So I hope it's worth it. I'm not going to lie. If we raise $10, it'll be worth it for me. But I would like to raise $10,000. So thanks for listening. If you're listening, if you have any interest, anything like that, please just, if anything, even if you don't have money to donate, I know I don't have any money to donate. Like, and I'm a lot of people are in my position. They're college kids, and they're also like, who is this guy? What's he doing? Blah, blah, blah. Just give me a share or a retweet. If you can't do the money, give me a share. Give me a retweet. Just something to help raise awareness. Or give someone a hug. Even if you can't do that, if you don't want to do anything social media, you don't want to give any money, just go out and give someone a hug, man. Just be nice to someone, and that will be satisfying. Oh, last thing, we will be doing a little fundraiser, hopefully, if everything goes planned, at like a bar or something. We're going to have hammer out the details of that. I'll put everything like that on our Facebook and our website. But kind of a send-off party to just raise a little bit more money that we can. And the last thing, I'm not taking any of this money. It's all going straight to the MS Society, every single thing. I probably should, because I don't know if I have a ton of money, and I could have used like a slush fund to grab some money just in case, kind of in case I get stuck or to make the trip better and everything like this. But I set it up through the National MS Society directly to them, so everything that we raise goes directly to them. So you don't have to worry about me taking it and using it on gas or using it on Cheeto chicken fries or Burger King or anything like that. All the money, anything you donate, every single cent is going straight to the National MS Society. It's not going in my pocket. I'm not making any money off of this. And I'm not saying that to my own horn. I'm kind of saying that because I didn't even think of a way to raise money for myself. But just know that it's not going to me, and it's going to a really, really, really good cause, a really good national society who's really doing their part to help make people's lives better. I know they've really helped out my mom, so just know it's going to a good place. It's not going to me. It's not going to beer. It's not going to partying, anything like that. It's going to people who need it, people who actually need it. So if you do donate, thank you so much. Bless your soul. It's awesome. I would love for you to do it. And like I said, I would love to be on the road as long as possible, raise as much money as possible. But if not, give someone a hug, give it a retweet, give it a share, do anything like that. Just be nice to someone. And that's it. That's the Keno Radio Podcast Across America tour. Hopefully I was entertaining enough for you to listen to the end. And if not, I gave a little plug in the middle so you know where to find everything. But like I said, again, Keno Radio on Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, just KenoRadio. Facebook.com/Keno Radio. It's our little page. KenoRadio@gmail.com if you want to hit us up with any inquiries or anything like that. www.kenoradio.wixsite.com/let's have some fun. And one last time, the donation page straight to their place is as follows. http://main.nationalmssociety.org/go-to/Keno Radio. Again, that's http://main.nationalmssociety.org/go-to/Keno Radio. So hammer those donate buttons. Let's get this thing going. Let's create content. Let's end multiple sclerosis. Let's get famous. Let's do everything. Let's have some fun. How about that? Let's have some fun. For Kyle, for Kicks, for Keno Radio. It's been fun. It's been fun talking to you doing this. Let's create some more fun. Let's create some money. Let's take this to the top. Everyone have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful week and a wonderful weekend. Stay tuned. This is going to be big. This is going to be fun. This is going to be big. Stay tuned. Thanks, everyone, for listening. Have a great day. Peace.
Man, I love college. Do I really have to graduate, or can I just stay here for the rest of my life?
Keno Radio. Keno.